OS2 is widely associated with IBM, who was positioning OS2 as a competing product to Microsoft Windows, especially Windows 95 and NT during the 90s.
While IBM's main goal may be to show once reluctant users that OS2 Warp is now a genuine alternative to Windows, the company also saw the Windows 95 delay as a rare opportunity, a chance to fill a gap left wide open by Microsoft.
Still, OS2 embraced Windows by offering not only DOS compatibility, but also Windows 3.x compatibility by means of WinOS 2 in release 2.x. But did you actually know that OS2 originally was a joint development project between IBM and Microsoft, and that during the 80s you would not only get IBM OS2 but also Microsoft OS2? And Microsoft went even as far as to license Microsoft OS2 to other OEMs like Compaq, as what they did in the years prior with their MS-DOS line of operating systems. We had OS2 at home during my younger years, though only the IBM variation of release 2.1 and later Warp 3.0. At this point, IBM and Microsoft had already parted ways. Never have I taken the opportunity to look at Microsoft OS2 1.x, but with the recent repair of these Compaq portable 3 machines, and for the reason that there is a Compaq OEM version, today I finally want to give it a try. Have you ever fixed an old computer? I did, many times. I'm the Vintage Collector, and these are my stories. I started off by recreating the 5¼-inch media for the Compaq OEM version of Microsoft OS2 release 1.1. I found it on winworldpc.com, and it seems to be a total fit for this Compaq Portable 3, which features an 8286 CPU and 6 MB of RAM. My first attempt at booting though was not a success, as it indefinitely hung on the boot screen. Well, I tried release 1.21 then, but to no avail. At least it gave me a more detailed crash report, though more on that later. My third attempt was with release 1.3.
This one as well?
Yes, also this one just hangs on the loading screen. I then started reading up, also trying to make sense from the crash dump we saw before. Eventually I found a hint that it could be related to bad memory. This machine is equipped with a third-party memory expansion module made by Kingston. I started swapping out memory modules, but except in one case, where I actually seemed to have swapped in a faulty module, I always got past the BIOS power on self-test. Still, with no visible effect on OS2, which just didn't want to boot up at all. I eventually found a website with some hints on making OS2 work on fast machines by applying a patch to the install disk. While it was mostly meant in context of modern day's computers, and especially virtualization, I didn't think it was applicable in context for me. Still, one of the error numbers I saw on my crash dump was exactly the same as mentioned on this webpage, so I gave it a shot anyways. They provide a Python script, which can do the heavy lifting for you. Beware though, that it needs Python 2, which is totally outdated and should only be installed with caution. Still, even the patch disk didn't do any good. For what it takes, I then put this high-screen Kalani 386 machine up to the test. And, big surprise, it seemed to be fine with either of the patched and unpatched disks, going past the boot screen and ending up in the installer. It seems like my Compaq 286 really does have an issue with OS2, but I can't nail it at this point in time. But as this high-screen machine runs a contemporary correct setup of the DRDOS 6 already, I didn't want to go into an install venture on this machine. But there is an alternative approach, PCEM. In contrast to software like VirtualBox or VMware, PCEM is really a PC emulator. It needs the specific ROMs for certain machines and components and really emulates them to the point. It can perfectly emulate a variety of systems, be it the original IBM PC or its successors, but also many others. It also has a compact portable emulation, but my attempts for running OS2 with it were a big time fail as well. So I again went with a generic 386 PC emulation, which brought up the setup screen and allowed me to run through the OS2 installation. I ended up having this desktop view, the so-called presentation manager, which looks very, very similar to Windows 3.0.
How did that come to be?
What we see here is OS 2 1.3, which was released in December 1990. Windows 3.0 came out in May 1990. The similarity of the UI being so close to each other, actually, even that close, that even the included file manager is merely the same and hard to tell apart from the Windows 3.0 counterpart, has a good reason. And this reason is to apply the same UI semantics and thus similar look and feel, so users would find themselves familiar right away. And it has yet another reason, which I will be talking about in a follow-up video. But for today, let's just dive around a bit and look at the control panels, which as well share a lot of familiarity with the Windows 3.0 counterpart. Or here, the OS2 system editor. Does it look like the Windows notepad? Yes, it does. And here, the system prompt.
Fun fact, the command processor for both Windows NT and OS2 is called cmd.exe.
Or here, the system properties for a presentation manager icon. Of course, it all makes sense and is well explainable, but for me, whom has never used OS 2 1.3, this feels really, really strange. But if you paid close attention, something is missing here. Right, the DOS emulation, something that was key to OS 2. Actually, I had forgotten to install it. And there is no way to do it in the aftermath from the presentation manager. You have to actually boot up with the setup disk once again and...
Nah, don't say you have to reinstall the whole thing now.
Well, no. It's counterintuitive and one might be tempted to think that's necessary. But the folks on IBM and Microsoft were clever and built in an option to give you the choice. So I'm going for the second choice for adding options. Namely, amongst some other things I left out before, the DOS environment. And after another reboot, we'll find this DOS icon on the bottom left, which drops us into a full-screen DOS session. This is the most striking difference to later versions of OS 2, where you could run the DOS environment also in windowed mode, and even multiples of them. In the 1.x series, you could only run one single DOS session, and this was restricted to full screen mode.
Was it possible to run Windows 3.0 and OS 2 at this point? Later releases could do that.
Well, no. I tried it. When OS 2 came only to be on the OS 2 2.x series. But what you could do was to install Microsoft Word and Microsoft Excel.
Wait a minute.
Yes, that was a point in time where Microsoft actually offered some of their products for OS 2. Although, it feels kinda out of place, as Microsoft Word for OS 2 kinda runs this text mode installer. And I would definitely need to look at it again, but if I remember correctly, Word for DOS 5.x used the same installer. Apart from this presentation manager version, Microsoft also released an OS 2 native version of Microsoft Word 5 and 5.5 in 1998 and 1991 respectively. Anyways, with this version, you won't end up with a text mode version of Microsoft Word, but an actual graphical application, which looks just like its Windows native counterpart. The setup for Microsoft Excel looks a lot like the contemporary Windows setup, except that it's missing the maximized background screen window with the splash screens. But it as well, once installed, looks exactly like the Windows counterpart. What's interesting on both are the copyrights, which are 1991 and 1992 respectively. So the two software packages came from a time where Microsoft already bailed out from the OS2 development and was fully focusing on Windows 3.x and Windows NT 3.1 in particular.
Did you know NT 3.1, coming out in 1993, so roughly 18 months after OS2 2.0, was supposed to be the next version of OS2?
Yes, but that's a story for another time. What's still interesting to mention is the fact that these graphical versions of Word and Excel were not really native OS2 applications. Microsoft ported a subset of the Windows libraries for OS2, given the acronym WLO, but pronounced as Willow. This allowed translation of the Windows 16-bit API calls into their OS2 counterparts. This technology was not only used in Word and Excel, but also for a package called Windows 3.0 Applets for OS2, which, no surprise, brought the well-known Windows 3.0 Applets onto OS2. And for anyone familiar with the Wine libraries, yes, that's basically the same concept carried on. Nah, that was nothing, was it? Nothing easier than installing an operating system, so I thought. And I really had hoped for installing the CompacOM version of Microsoft OS2 onto that Compact Portable 3 machine. At least, this commodity 386 machine seemed to be more than willing to install OS2 release 1.1. And if it weren't for the current system setup with DRDOS 6, the contemporary correct setting for Vobis high screen computers at the time, I would have definitely done it. Yet, PCEM proved a success, though not what I had originally intended for. It reminds me of that SGI soft Windows venture, which also turned out to become a virtualization venture. Anyways, I still have this IBM P70, which hopefully should be good for an early OS2 release, and I'll be definitely giving it a second time round when I happen to be fixing this machine. I'm the Vintage Collector, and this was my story. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. If you check out this channel's community tab, you'll find some polls on potential upcoming videos. You're very welcome to upvote on upcoming topics or drop in new ones you'd like me to chase down.